Hey everyone, welcome back to my channel. Today I will be telling you how I got a job at Louis Vuitton at the tender age of 19. Now, some of you have been asking how I was able to get a job at LV at such a young age, and I will tell you. If you are new to my channel, welcome. If you are a returning subscriber, welcome back. I recently revealed that I used to work for LV for many years at multiple locations, and I recently have been spilling all the tea, all the behind the scenes background information and stories from my time with LV. So if you are interested in that, then go ahead and subscribe. Hit the notification bell so you can watch the next video when it comes out. There is no secret formula. I didn't know anyone. There is no kind of insider information, but I just had, at that point, I had several years of customer service experience under my belt. My very first job, I was 14 years old and I was a waitress at my friend's family-owned restaurant. So I was a food server. Yeah, or whatever the PC term is. I don't think they call them waiter or waitress anymore. It's like server. But I identified as a waitress. And so yeah, I was a waitress. I think that everyone, I don't know, I just think that it's such a great job because you learn so many skills. You learn so many things. You learn how to multitask, how to deal with difficult customers, how to deal with difficult colleagues, how to adapt to changing circumstances. So yeah, I was a waitress and I was 14. And so, you know, at that time, it definitely was not an official job in terms of, you know, I was basically under the table, paid in cash, earn cash tips. But at 16, when I was legally able to work an official job with a W-2, I worked my first retail job at a local boutique at the mall. So I was a sales associate. And so that was my first experience in fashion, styling outfits. The boutique I worked at was it wasn't a well-known brand, but they did have several locations. And so that's where I became familiar with retail customers. Register, you know, inventory, stocking, styling, outfits. Yeah, so I worked there for about a year and then I moved up. And you know, when you work in the mall, when you're a mall employee, you kind of maybe are always on the hunt for a better job, or I was at the time. So after that, I worked at a different boutique, and this was a well-known international brand. It's not luxury, but it definitely is not, you know, like Gap or Banana Republic prices. They're pretty expensive. Another women's fashion brand. They were famous for their dresses, but they also had active wear, casual wear. I just gained a lot more knowledge about styling and customers. When you talk about retail horror stories, that was probably where I had the worst customer experiences in terms of just rude customers and just kind of gross experiences. One of my recent videos, I talked about the grossest customer repair that came in. And this place that I worked had it beat. I actually made a lot of money there. I made more money at this kind of a non-luxury brand because it was commission-based. And I mentioned in my LV salary video that at the time, LV employees did not earn commission. They do now, and I can probably do an updated video talking about the differences in the perks and benefits and the pay structure, but at the time, I did not make commission at LV. I worked at this contemporary women's clothing brand, and then I just decided, you know, I love LV. I love the brand. I love the history. I love that it's such a recognizable name. You know, my family overseas, they are familiar with the brand. So I just thought, you know, why not? So I went in and I just applied. And this was before Instagram, before Facebook, before LinkedIn. I literally called directly the boutique. And this was before all the calls to boutiques redirected and rerouted to the call center. So I called the boutique directly and I spoke to a sales associate. And I asked, you know, if they were hiring, and she transferred me to the operations manager, who said yes, they were hiring, and to just go ahead and come in person, you know, with my resume and apply. So I did. I printed out a resume, you know, on hard copy paper. I put it in a nice portfolio. I wore all black. I had my hair either tied back or tied up in a bun. I had very minimal makeup and I just was dressed in all black. I did use my Speedy, but then I had a portfolio with my resume. I went and I dropped it off in person. And then later that day, they called me directly and scheduled an interview later that week. I went in On that same day, I went and I interviewed with the leather goods manager. And then immediately after that, she left the room. And then the store director came in and interviewed me. So it was two back-to-back interviews. They went very well, obviously, because then I got to my car and I was driving home and they called within 30 minutes of me leaving and offered me the position. And it was as client advisor. I'll post a separate video with interview tips, like specific interview tips and concrete examples, and also the difference in the hiring process now, because again, it is very different. I am seeing now some of my friends who are currently in the hiring process or who have recently been hired by LV, things are very different. And whereas my hiring was pretty quick, it was a pretty quick turnaround, it is just not that way. Now there are so many different kind of hoops you have to go through. You have to speak with talent acquisition reps, and then there are different rounds of interviews. There are group interviews, which I was like, what group interview? That's crazy. So I will go into all the logistics and the interview tips later in another video, but I just wanted to give you a background. If you're interested in applying to Louis Vuitton or any other luxury retail company, again, this is specifically for a client advisor position. Obviously, there are tons of different positions. You know, if you live close to San Dimas, you can work in the repair facility. There's lots of different positions just with any typical company, you know, finance, HR. But I'm talking about if you are interested in working, you know, on the ground in the boutique as a client advisor. What I found to be very helpful, and I know this because I asked and because I worked for LV for so many years. So if you're interested in working for LV, you don't need years and years of experience, and you don't even need experience in high-end retail, because obviously everyone has to get a start somewhere. And for me, and for many others who work for LV, that's their first luxury brand that they work for. But you really need to have basic customer service experience, and specifically retail experience. Now for me, I was a waitress and then I worked in retail. So I had pretty much all of it covered. And I remember even when I started working, I spoke to my manager, and this is the one I mentioned in my toxic work environment video. She was my favorite manager. She was great. She was very inspiring, very motivating. And I asked her, you know, I'm pretty young. Like, I'm like the youngest person here. The boutique that I worked at, a lot of the client advisors were twice my age. Some of them were, you know, had been there for years and years and years. They were grandparents. I was 19 when they hired me, and I just was like, you know, what made you hire me, I guess? And she basically told me that in her experience working, she had worked for LV for years, and she worked for them for years after I left. She had the most success hiring employees who were former waiters and waitresses. Because number one, they are able to multitask, okay? Because when you work in, as a server, as a waiter or waitress, it is a very high-paced, high-energy, ever-changing environment, okay? Things change, there's a lot of tensions, you're running around, literally running, you're juggling food orders, you know, multiple orders, multiple tables. If something is out, you need to be able to quickly adapt and make recommended suggestions for something similar. You have to be able to kind of read the customer and recommend something similar that they might like, you know, find out what their tastes are, and then offer, you know, alternatives if there is something that they want that's unavailable. She found that those skills you gain working as a server translate easily and really help you excel working as a client advisor. And then working in retail, even though, again, I didn't work in high-end luxury retail at that point, a lot of those skills similarly translate. You deal with inventory, you deal with customers, you learn how to fashion outfits for them. One thing they really value is being able to push multiple items in one transaction. So when a customer is coming in and they want to buy maybe just a purse, you are able to then encourage them to look into a matching wallet, and also maybe look into a matching belt. And also, oh, look, these shoes match the belt. And oh, don't you want a hat to go with those shoes? It all bodes well when you're able to style a customer and cross sell in multiple departments. If you have that experience working in another retail company, then that's something that they really value at LV. They also want to see that you can develop long-term relationships with clients. You know, they don't want people to just come in once and then that's it. They want people to come in, you know, enjoy their experience and return and purchase multiple items and recommend it to family and friends. You know, they want you to follow up and be able to maintain and cultivate a long-lasting relationship with customers. And so if you can show that you've done that in the past, whether it's as a waitress, you know, in my case, where you have regulars come in and order the same thing every week, you know, that's one example where you're able to do that. And instead of selling them a meal, you're selling them, you know, a bag every season or something. Probably a new thing that we didn't use when I worked for LV, because again, the tech just wasn't there. And this may vary because I see the comments in some of my other videos. I see these days that there are some client advisors that actually have an entire social media page just for their, you know, LV employment. So it'll be like LV advisor, Saks, and then their name. So people will follow them and then they'll post in their stories or in a new post, you know, new inventory that's come in, especially like hot trending items that are sometimes usually out of stock. And that's how they sell, you know, in this day and age. They're really making the most of the tech that they have on hand, especially considering now with everything that's been happening, that really helped them to their advantage because they're able to sell throughout the country. You can sell across, you know, different states. So this is a little tricky because you might not want to bring this up at the interview, but if you can develop and maintain like a social presence, that might help you in the long run. Now, again, you might want to wait and feel out the hiring manager or the interviewer, because some places are more okay with selling through social media than others. So maybe hold off on that. But if that comes up, you know, follow their lead and say, yes, I can definitely, you know, I have long lasting customers. I've, you know, utilized social media, Facebook groups, Instagram hashtags, and that's how some clients have found me. And actually, that's how I have found some hard to find items from LV. One of my videos, I gave tips on how to find very hard to find items, especially during a price increase when there's like a mad dash to get these. Maybe the younger managers who are very familiar and who embrace social media, they are more likely to respond well if you can also utilize that technology and that social presence in order to sell and to reach out to more customers. That was my history. I was a waitress and then I worked in retail at contemporary brands. And then I just decided one day to apply to LV and I applied and I was hired. Everyone's story is different. Everyone's employment is different and every boutique is different. I would recommend applying directly at the LV website. I know that like with seasonal employees, you can also apply through employment websites like Indeed or maybe monster.com. Either way, the seasonal employees, they don't get discounts. You can certainly apply to be a seasonal employee if you want to get your foot in the door. I mentioned in my LV toxic work environment video, seasonal employees don't get discounts and they often aren't always hired after the season is over. Some of them do get hired into the regular rotation, but it's not always the case. So if your goal is to eventually work for LV, you know, it certainly can help, but it's a whole different process and it's just not guaranteed. So if you can, if there is a spot available, I would recommend applying to be a regular LV employee. If there's no opening, then okay, sure, seasonal employee is probably the next best option. So if you work for LV or any other luxury retailer, let us know, what was your employment history like? When I worked for LV, it was interesting to see where people were coming from. You know, not everyone worked in retail. I just found that it really helped to have a good foundation in customer service, whether that was in another fashion company or as a waitress in my case. So I hope you found this video helpful. Again, I will follow up with another video giving specific interview tips and talking about the questions that they ask. So if you're interested in that, then go ahead and subscribe and hit the notification bell. But I hope you enjoyed. Thanks so much for watching and I hope to catch you in my next video. Bye.